Let me welcome you to the Cathedral of the Incarnation in the Diocese of Maryland, to those of you who are here in the church itself, and to those of you who are joining us online. I'm Robert Ihloff. I'm the assisting bishop of the Diocese of Maryland, and I'm glad to welcome you to this special service of ordination. We are going to be ordaining five persons to the transitional diaconate: Lauren Bloom, Mark Lobb, Columba Salamony, Kathleen Schotto, Sara Yoe. Kathy Boyer will be our preacher. Kathy has been one of the mentors for EBM, which is our euphemism for looking at ministry in its broadest sense. And all five of our ordinands went through EBM with Kathy as one of their mentors, and they unanimously chose her to be the preacher at this service. For those of you who are here in the cathedral, please keep your mask on, except when you're actually receiving communion. And for those of you watching online, please download the bulletin. It has everything you need to fully participate in this service. We begin our worship in song. Let us sing together, O God Beyond All Praising.
Thank you.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us say together, Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Have they been selected in accordance with the canons of this church, and do you believe their manner of life to be suitable to the exercise of this ministry?
We serve God to you, that they have satisfied the requirements of the canons, and we believe them qualified for this order.
Will you be loyal to the doctrine, discipline, and worship of Christ, as this church has received them? And will you, in accordance with the canons of this church, obey your bishop and other ministers who may have authority over you and your work?
I am willing and ready to do so, and I solemnly declare that I do believe the Holy Scriptures of the Old and New Testament to be the Word of God, and to contain all things necessary to salvation, and I do solemnly doctrine, discipline, and worship of the Episcopal Church.
Please sign the declaration. The congregation may be seated. Please rise as you are able. Dear friends in Christ, you know the importance of this ministry and the weight of your responsibility in presenting Lauren, Mark, Columba, Kathleen, and Sarah for the ordination to the Sacred Order of Deacons. Therefore, if any of you know any impediment or crime because of which we should not proceed, come forward now and make it known. Is it your will that Lauren, Mark, Columba, Kathleen, and Sarah be ordained as deacons?
It is.
Will you uphold them in this ministry?
We will.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy on us.
We pray to you, Lord Christ.
grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. O God of unchangeable power and eternal life, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things that were being cast down are being raised up, and things that had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations." Then I said, "Ah, Lord God, truly I do not know how to speak, for I am only a child." But the Lord said to me, "Do not say, 'I am only a child,' for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and you shall speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth and said to me, "Now I have put my words in your mouth." The word of the Lord. Let's pray in unison Psalms 84.
How dear to me is your dwelling, O God.
Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. And the 12 called together the whole community of the disciples and said, "It is not right that we should neglect the word of God in order to wait on tables. Therefore, friends, select from among yourselves 7 men of good standing, full of the Spirit and of wisdom, whom we may appoint to this task, while we, for our part, will devote ourselves to prayer and to serving the word." What they said pleased the whole community, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and the Holy Spirit, together with Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicolaus, a proselyte of Antioch. They had these men stand before the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. The word of God continued to spread. The number of the disciples increased greatly in Jerusalem, and a great many of the priests became obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Be ready and keep your lamps burning, just like those servants who wait up for their masters to return from a wedding feast. As soon as he comes and knocks, they open the door for him. Servants are fortunate if their master finds them awake and ready when he comes. I promise you that he will get ready and have his servants sit down so he can serve them. Those servants are really fortunate if their master finds them ready, even though he comes late at night or early in the morning. The Gospel of the Lord.
Seated. Good morning. My name is Kathy Boryer, and I'm a member of St. Mark's in Highland, Maryland. I'm also a retired high school social studies teacher, mom, grandmother, and for the last 13 years, the lay member for DOV, Discerning Ordained Vocation. And I'm standing in this spot today. Still a mystery to me, for this occasion, because Lauren, Mike, Mark, Columba, Ryan. Let me start that over again. Because Lauren, Mark, Columba, Kathleen, and Sarah thought it was a good idea. So if at the conclusion of this you determine it was not, please feel free to take it up with them and Bishop Ihloff. All kidding aside, thank you for this amazing opportunity, something I never dreamed possible and something I will never forget. I've been a lay preacher at St. Mark's for several years, so I'm not a complete novice at this, but speaking in front of this many collars, one purple shirt, and such a large gathering of friends and family is quite new to me. I don't know about you, but 2021 has been a pretty wild and crazy year, so perhaps this opportunity is God's way of reminding me to stay alert, be ready for the new, the different, and the totally unexpected. So what to say to the five ordinands today? Well, you know me, I've been thinking about it. And I thought this week that at a time when so many in the various helping professions, doctors, nurses, first responders, teachers, clergy, are fleeing their professions, you have decided to step into the breach. You've said yes. Count me in for whatever lies ahead in 2022 and beyond. You have certainly experienced the changes and consequences of COVID, and we all know we're not quite out of the woods yet. None of us knows what lies ahead, but we are here today to send you on your way to whatever God has in store for you. So what will be required of you from this point forward? Well, you know I'm going to have some suggestions, so here goes. Creativity, flexibility, patience, wisdom, a very good sense of humor, as well as an abundance of humility, grace, charm, and courage. No matter where you are called to serve God, you are going to find yourself in need of all of these things on a regular basis. You will need to hone your listening skills so that you can be fully present to both individuals and the communities that you will be called to serve and lead. Leaving the things that easily distract you, worry you, encumber your ability to be fully present and listen, and to be that calm presence are best confined to time with your spiritual director, trusted colleagues, or a professional counselor. In a time of so much noise, so much meaningless chatter, division, you are going to need to be a person whose words and actions bring life and light and hope into the darkness. You will need to make time for silence and solitude, a time and a place where you can listen to the voice of God, a time and place when you are silent and God has your undivided attention. You will need to travel light, ever ready to respond to new and changing circumstances. Just as the servants had their master's house in order in anticipation of his return, you will need to be ready. The knock or the call or the email or the conversation may come at a time you could never have predicted. And the question will be, will you be ready? You will need to wear your collar with humility, grace, and dignity. For me, a clerical collar is a sign of hope, a reminder that frail and wobbly human beings can say yes to God, be set aside, and be the hands and feet of God in the world. Wear it gently. Wear it carefully. It is not a weapon or a sign of superiority. Wear it as a baptized child of God in whose presence one can feel safe, fully welcomed, and respected. You will need to practice good self-care so you are physically, emotionally, and spiritually fit to serve and lead. take time off. Shut down the gadgets. Turn off the TV and the radio. Save that podcast for later. Minimize the distractions. Read widely. Play like a child. Laugh out loud and often. Be attentive to your mind, body, and spirit. And set healthy boundaries around your time and energy so that you and those you serve can thrive. You will now be tasked with the proclamation of the gospel. How will you proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ in both your words and actions? You will now be responsible for setting the table with bread and wine. How will you serve and help feed both body and soul with the only food and drink that satisfies? How will you make everyone feel welcome at the table? I know this sounds like a lot, and it is. But here's the good news. You aren't in this alone. Take a look around you. Those present here today and those watching and listening from remote locations have been with you from the start. They've listened, asked you very good questions, challenged you, and encouraged you. They've provided both feedback and pushback. Just a few minutes ago, we said, "It is," when asked if it was our will that you be ordained. And we've also just promised to uphold you in this ministry. You did not arrive at this point in your life all by yourself, and you are not expected to go it alone from this day forward. Ask for help, guidance, advice when you need it. Draw on the wisdom and experience of your bishop, your clergy colleagues, and the lay men and women that will be in those communities that you will serve. Asking for help is not a sign of weakness, but a sign of maturity. No one is expecting you to be perfect or to have all the answers, so don't place that impossible burden on your shoulders. Now, here's the really, really, really good news. And that is that the God who has called you, who has brought you to this day, will never abandon you or walk away. I don't believe God expects any of us to be perfect or have easy answers to every question. But I do believe all of us, and especially the five of you, you are called to be faithful, always ready to serve, always ready to pick up and go, willfully and joyfully using every skill, talent, gift, and passion you have to both serve and lead. So, dear ones, proclaim the gospel. Set the table. Wear that collar with dignity and grace and joy. Serve God and the world in ways that bring light, joy, hope, and grace to a world that we know is hurting and fractured. Build bridges. Be the bridge. Be brave. Be the one who welcomes all in the name of Christ. No need to be perfect. No need to have every answer. Just be the amazing human being God created you to be, and all manner of things shall be well. Godspeed. I can't wait to see what's next.
Beloved children of God, every Christian is called to follow Jesus Christ, serving God through the power of the Holy Spirit. God now calls you to the special ministry of servanthood directly under your bishop. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are to serve all people, particularly the poor, the weak, the sick, and the lonely. As a deacon in the church, you are to study the Holy Scriptures, to seek nourishment from them, and to model your life upon them. You are to make Christ and his redemptive love known by word and example to those among whom you live, work, and worship. You are to assist the bishop and priests in public worship and in the ministration of God's word and sacraments, and you are to carry out other duties assigned to you from time to time. At all times, your life and teaching are to show Christ's people that in serving the helpless, they are serving Christ himself. My friends, brothers and sisters, do you believe that you are truly called by God and the Church to the life and work of a deacon?
I believe I am so called.
Do you now, in the presence of the Church, commit yourself to this trust and responsibility?
I do.
Will you be guided by the pastoral direction and leadership of your bishop?
I will.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the reading and study of Holy Scriptures?
I will.
Will you look for Christ in all others, being ready to help and serve those in need?
I will.
Will you do your best to pattern your life and that of your family in accordance with the teachings of Christ, so that you may be a wholesome example to all people?
I will.
Will you in all things seek not your glory, but the glory of the Lord Christ?
I will.
May the grace of God uphold you in the service that God has laid upon you. Amen. The congregation, please stand. God, the Creator of all, we praise you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, who took on himself the form of a servant and humbled himself, becoming obedient even to the death on the cross. We praise you that you have highly exalted him and made him Lord of all, and that through him we know that whoever would be great must be servant of all. We praise you for the many ministries of your church and for calling these your servants to the order of deacons. The congregation may be seated. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Lauren. Fill her with grace and power, and make her a deacon in your church. Make her, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let her life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through her many may come to know you and love you. As your Son came not to be served, but to serve, may this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him with whom you and the Holy Spirit live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Mark. Fill him with your grace and power, and make him a deacon in your church. Make him, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let his life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through him many may come to know you and love you. As your Son came not to be served, but to serve, may this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Columba. Fill him with grace and power, and make him a deacon in your church. Make him, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let his life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through him many may come to know you and love you. As your Son came not to be served, but to serve, may this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him with whom the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Kathleen. Fill her with grace and power, and make her a deacon in your church. Make her, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let her life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through her many may come to know you and love you. As your Son came not to be served, but to serve, may this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him with whom and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Sarah. Fill them with grace and power, and make them a deacon in your church. Make them, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let their life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through them many may know you and love you. As your Son came not to be served, but to serve, may this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God, forever and ever. Amen. You may all rise. The vesting of our new deacons will now take place. Lauren, this way. Sorry, watch your step. Lauren, receive this Bible as a sign of your authority to proclaim God's word and to assist in the ministration of the holy sacraments. And congratulations. Mark, receive this Bible as a sign of your authority to proclaim the word of God and to assist in the ministration of the holy sacraments. Amen. God bless you. Congratulations. Columba, receive this Bible as a sign of your authority to proclaim the word of God and to assist in the ministration of the holy sacraments. Amen. God bless you. Just checking to make sure that the Bible was really in here. It is. Kathleen, receive this Bible as a sign of the authority to proclaim God's word and to assist in the ministration of the holy sacraments. God bless you. Step. Sara, receive this Bible as a sign of your authority to proclaim God's word and to assist in the ministration of the holy sacraments. God bless you. Please rise as you are able. And even though it doesn't say this at this point, I'd like you all to greet our newest deacons in the Episcopal Church. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. Go ahead.
may be seated. Welcome again, everyone. I'm Rob Bolter, the Dean and Executive Producer of this Cathedral Church of the Episcopal Diocese of Maryland. That's kind of an inside joke if you were here for the rehearsal. I'm so glad that you've joined us today. What a glorious day for the church. What a wonderful celebration. I just want to give you a couple of notes about some logistics around Holy Communion. We will have standing communion stations of bread only, and the five new deacons will be across the front steps here. You may come forward and receive the Holy Communion from whomever you wish. Don't feel like there'll be any feelings hurt if you wait for the person of your choice. There are also gluten-free wafers in each paten, so if you'd like a gluten-free wafer, please let your deacon know that that's what you would like. There will be ushers who will show you the way. We're just going to take our time with it and not clump up too much in the center aisle, so just do what the ushers tell you, will you? Thank you very much. Come down the center aisle and then come to the forward and go back through the side aisles so we kind of minimize kind of bumping into each other. In a moment, we're going to be passing the offering baskets, and the money that you will give will help to defray the cost of this service. And then the remainder is going to be given to Camp Spirit Song at the Claggett Retreat Center. This was the place that the ordinance said that they would like the money to go to. This is Camp Spirit Song at the Claggett Retreat Center. Now, there's also a link in the bulletin where you can make a gift online, and so all the information is there in the bulletin. And then the final thing is that right as the service ends, the ordinands will then come forward with the bishop and will have photo opportunities to come forward and take as many photos as you wish. So please let the ordinands come back after the final procession to come back up to the altar to be with Bishop Ihloff. And Bishop Ihloff, I hand it off to you.
I'm hiding. I wanted to say that it is a great pleasure for me to be able to ordain particularly these five persons, because I'm the bishop who is responsible for people in the ordination track in the diocese. And I have been following closely their careers over the last 2 years that I've been serving back in the diocese. And a few of them I have known longer than that. They are wonderful people. And I just want to comment on the historical aspect of this. It has been a long Catholic tradition to ordain persons first to the diaconate and then, if they are moving on to the priesthood, as all five of these persons are. So you'll be invited to another ordination in approximately 6 months, and that will be more personal and probably in the parish that they're serving. It's tempting to think of this as a hierarchy, but I want to dissuade you from that. In fact, persons are ordained to the diaconate first, not because it's a stepping stone to priesthood, but because it is absolutely essential that anyone who presumes to be ordained should understand in the depths of their heart how important it is to minister to the poor, the disadvantaged, and those who are in need. This is a basic part of the gospel of Christ, a basic part of our own baptismal covenant. Every person is called to serve God in the world. And I'm banking on the fact that these five deacons will actually take this 6 months to lay to heart how they can proclaim to the church the needs, hopes, and concerns of the world. I say that because after they're ordained to the priesthood, they will become experts at proclaiming to the church the needs of the church. But what the church really needs is people to proclaim to the church the needs of the world, which is where we daily meet Jesus and find our own ministries as laity, deacons, priests, and bishops. Oh. Let your light so shine that all may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven.
Thank you.
As your bulletin indicates, in this church, all persons who desire to receive the body and blood of Christ are welcome to do so. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise. Glory to you forever and ever. At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home. By your will, they were created and have their being. From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another. Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight. Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages you revealed your righteous law, and in the fullness of time you sent your only Son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace. By his blood he reconciled us. By his wounds we are healed. Therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn. And so, Almighty God, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving, we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming. Lord God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Hannah, and Ruth, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at the work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name. Risen Christ, thank us. Accept these prayers and praises, O God, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor and glory and worship from generation to generation. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ keep you in everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the holy food of the body and blood of your Son, and for uniting us through him in the fellowship of your Holy Spirit. We thank you for raising up among us faithful servants for the ministry of your word and sacraments. We pray that Lauren, Mark, Columba, Kathleen, and Sarah may be to us effective examples in word and action, in love and patience, and in holiness of life. Grant that we with them may serve you now and always rejoice in your glory through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Minister to the afflicted. Share your faith on a daily basis and bring the concerns of the world into the church. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.